Good morning, everybody, and thank you for coming and sitting there. And I hope you're enjoying the rest of this event. My topic for today is dry needling. And the reason I came up with this topic because it's kind of hot and unique intervention being practiced by physiotherapists. And I feel we're still behind about it, based or compared to other countries. They are ahead of us. Like I heard in Bahrain, in Kuwait, in UAE, they already started practice dry needling, but still here we're kind of shy or unencouraged regarding practice dry needling as a scope, physical therapy scope of practice. That's why it's a good opportunity to bring it on the table to discussion, to discuss about it and to see where are we regarding dry needling. So my headlines for this presentation. Dry needling overview. The U.S. reports on experience studying dry needling to physical therapy scope of practice. We call the trends between dry needling and acupuncture, because acupuncturists hear from time to time some clients or programs, and even practitioners. They don't know about the core difference. They're not aware about the difference between acupuncture and dry needling. This is not fair. That's fair to me and then not fair to others. Last, but not least, I'm going to go over even if this practice. So, dry needling, what's dry needling? How many of you are practicing dry needling? Please raise your hand. Anyone? Email, two, three. So dry needling is a unique intervention being practiced by physiotherapist by using a filiform needle in order to penetrate the skin, stimulating defensive tissues for management of neuromuscular skeletal pain and movement impairment. The theoretical genesis, the origin of dry needling being brought to the media by Janine and Simon in 1999, and I have seen in the other sources 1940s by using a hypodermic injection of the classic syringe. Breaking down the trigger points. By the time we went out, the approach being categorized to two techniques, superficial and deep dry needling based on the indication and your indication and your application. And depends on the patient tolerance. The modern practice of dry needling has switched to use a filiform needle instead of using a hypodermic syringe or injection, because it's been reported that going over hypodermic syringe it will make a big or huge damage to soft tissue. So what are trigger points? As a definition, it's a hyper-rotable spots within the glute bands of already contracted skeletal muscles that produce local and referred pain. And trigger points is a source of muscles, nociceptors, and peripheral sources of persistent and susceptible focus that will contribute to development of peripheral and central sensitization. And how did the trigger points will be involved? The scenario starts when the blood circulation is disturbed. By any reason, by doing strenuous, repetitive injuries, by think of it like doing too much mousing, too much gardening, too much handwriting,
all that will, for some reason, will disturb the blood circulation. And when the blood circulation is compromised, the contraction takes place, then the ischemic hypoxia will be there. And eventually, the pH level of the soft tissue will be lower. This is the kind of red blood. And when the pH level isn't normalized by improving the blood circulation, the soft tissue will be latched and black. Then the trigger point will show up. And this is clear.
Reducing will be subsided.